us. I'm Jake, and my parents have left me home alone. Which is scary because I'm only 8 years old. But the silver lining is that being eight, I have an intuitive understanding of thermodynamics, mechanical engineering, and just physics in general. Which is good because there have been a lot of robberies in my neighborhood. So to protect myself, I've recreated some traps from the movie Home Alone. Now there have been videos and articles about this before, about how damaging the traps would be. But nobody's recreated them physically and tested them on a human body. Or in our case, a ballistics dummy. So we're going to test two traps that I've always found to be fascinating. The red hot door handle and paint can to the face. As a bonus, even though this isn't a trap, the crowbar to the chest, because that just has to be dangerous. That is if you even made it past the first two. Oh, I think I hear the bandits coming towards the house. I'm gonna go get ready.
Hey, hey, we're the Threadbanger Bandits, here to rob all these empty houses, right, Corinne?
That's right, Rob. We're about to knock off this little 8-year-old kid's house because it's not like he could set up a bunch of intricate traps that could seriously hurt us or anything, right?
Exactly. You go check the front door. I'm gonna go check the back.
Now we need to heat up a door handle to such a literal degree that it glows red, becomes incandescent. That is the emission of electromagnetic radiation from a hot body that makes it visible. In the film, they use an electric barbecue lighter placed on the interior side of the door, and the heat then transfers from the brass knob through the steel spindle and into the exterior knob. One thing to consider before we start: the object that is holding the hot door handle. The door is metal, but the interior of it is wood and foam. So if I had to hypothesize what happened, if we heat the knob close to 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit, the temperature at which it will glow, then the metal door will start to warp, and the foam and wood inside will combust into flame, which wouldn't be good. But there's only one way to know for sure. After 30 minutes, the interior door handle got to around 900 degrees Fahrenheit. The external doorknob, only about 65 degrees Fahrenheit. It's taking a very long time. So to speed things up, we're going to use this map gas torch to get things a little bit hotter, a little bit more quickly. The exterior doorknob only got to about 115 degrees Fahrenheit, which still wouldn't be that pleasant to touch, but wouldn't do that much damage. The interior doorknob, however, we got up to a total temperature of 1400 degrees Fahrenheit, which is incredibly hot. To test how badly it would burn, instead of using a hand, we used pork belly, which has similar skin thickness, and held it on the door handle for 3 seconds, like in the film. And the burn results were pretty similar to the movie and pretty severe. But more importantly, what did happen, which I thought would, is that the interior of the door lit on fire. The wood, the foam burned, the metal right here warped. We actually could see some fire coming out of the doorknob. Over hours, you could probably get the exterior doorknob to heat up, probably not hot enough to actually glow, to be incandescent. But the interior doorknob definitely would get there over a long enough period of time. Let's move on. And it should be noted that with this going for hours, the door would most likely totally light on fire, which kind of defeats the entire purpose, because then the villains could just walk right in. So, you know. The hot doorknob is very similar to the blowtorch to the head trap from the film, which my friend Mark Rober and I tested on his channel. And speaking of skulls and Mark Rober, let's find out what would happen if a can full of paint were to hit you in the face. To help explain, the star of my favorite black and white gangster film, Angles with Filthy Physics, mechanical engineer Mark Rober.
I'm gonna give you to the count of 10 to get you ugly, yellow, no good.
Oh, Vsauce, it's you. Let's talk paint can to the face physics. So, a standard gallon of paint weighs about 13 pounds. Now, in the movie, they drop this from the top of the stairs when the bandits are about halfway up. That means as the can falls, it picks up speed as the gravitational potential energy is converted to kinetic. And if you actually do the math, it works out to about 17 miles per hour. But that's if you just release the can from a standstill. If you actually give it a little bit of a shove, you now have a 13-pound gallon of paint coming at your face at 20 miles per hour. Now, if we assume your face crumples a bit and stops this paint can in about 3/4 of an inch of travel, that puts the impact force at 12 kilonewtons. That is like getting bare knuckle punched by Mike Tyson twice at one time. 12 kilonewtons is 6 times more than the force required to break your nose. Then, if we take that force and divide by the mass of your head, that means your head snaps back at 266 Gs. Which means there is virtually a 100% chance you would get knocked out and a 42% chance your skull would actually crack. Now, where was I? Oh yeah, I'm gonna give you 10 seconds to get your no good, yellow belly, ugly, dirty, rotten keister out of here.
As Mark was saying, your skull cracking is definitely not good. Also because the way the can would hit the head, the bandits would most likely experience an unhealthy amount of whiplash, causing even more damage to the brain. After this trap, your burgling days are most likely over.
Hey! He's at the top of the stairs!
My hand's pretty burnt. I think I have to go to the hospital.
Oh, come on, let's get him.
Time to test the trap. To the face would be incredibly devastating, which I feel is kind of an understatement. But luckily for us, the Threadbagger Bandits are very, very tough. So this brings us to our last test, a crowbar to the chest. I just need one thing. Oh, here it is. Yeah!
Ah! Why is this happening to me?
Rob, what are you doing?
Don't move.
Rob.
The crowbar weighs about 5 pounds and is swinging through the air at around 35 miles per hour. It will deliver a total force of 15,000 newtons, about 4.5 times the amount of force needed to break an average human rib. It broke through the skin, 7 ribs, and in this test, actually punctured the lungs and heart. Okay, so after doing these tests, what did we find out? Well, the hot door handle would get very, very, very hot given enough time, a very long time. You would get third-degree burns on your hand, and you would probably have to go to a hospital. You wouldn't be able to use this baby for the rest of the night. Then we get to the paint can to the head, which is devastating and really cool, but really devastating. That would be the end of your robbing career, and you probably wouldn't really walk away from it. But you do somehow, and we get to crowbar to the chest, which not only breaks your ribs, but also punctures your internal organs, and that's not good, and you should really go see a doctor at this point if this happens to you, please. This is just a PSA from me to you. So could you survive the Home Alone traps? Most likely, probably, pretty much, no, you couldn't. Which makes me think that I should check on Rob and Corinne. And as always, thanks for watching. Huge thank you to Lowe's for not only sponsoring this video, but for giving us this amazing set to work with and just being incredible partners to work with. They made a really great BTS video behind the scenes on their channel. You can check out right here. Shows how they made it, shows how we worked on it, does the whole process of making this production. Okay, I'm gonna get away from this
But you stay and watch, you know? It's like a fireplace with a door.